I'm Kent Tritle, Director of Cathedral Music at the Cathedral of St. John the Divine in New York City. My predecessor, who's celebrating his centennial this year, Alec Wyton, was the music director from 1954 until 1974. I was privileged to know Alec from the mid-1980s. He made a presentation on the 1982 hymnal, the Episcopal hymnal, which is an extraordinary hymnal. He was very involved in coordinating the committee that put that hymnal together. And he made a presentation for the New York City American Guild of Organists, if I'm correct, at the choir room of St. James Church, Madison Avenue, where Alec served until 1987 after leaving the cathedral in 1974. Alec spoke of the tenets that were the advisory elements which guided the committee in assembling that extraordinary 1982 hymnal. And I was very, very inspired. I was inspired by the person and inspired by his kindness to me. In that moment, I was able to invite Alec out to Hitchcock Presbyterian Church, where I was director of music from 86 to 89. He gave a wonderful presentation on Psalm 100, "Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord." We performed and sang a lot of his music in service, and he gave the sermon or address, worked with the choirs. It was a joyous, joyous experience. Later, when I went to St. Ignatius, I contacted Alec to say, "Hey, I think we can do all kinds of psalmody here. How about Anglican chant?" He had, of course, advised and overseen the put together of the Anglican chant Psalter, which corresponded with the 1982 hymnal, and also the Plain Song Psalter for that matter. So I took an Anglican chant lesson with Alec. It was another joyous encounter. I was so happy to have known him. Now through the years, my partner Arthur and I have been dear friends with Richard Wyton and his wife Barbara, and we treasure the legacy of Alec. We treasure the legacy at the cathedral. I had no idea when I met Alec those years ago that I might actually follow in his steps at St. John the Divine. We've been building the program now for 10 years, and I would like to think that Alec would be very, very happy with what we are doing these days. Alec, you're an inspiration. We think of you often. Happy birthday.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
I'm Raymond Nagem, Associate Director of Music at St. John the Divine, and it's a great honor today to play some music by Alec Wyton in honor of his 100th birthday. The piece you just heard was the Suite in Praise of Merbecke. John Merbecke was an English Reformation composer who was possibly the first to set words from the Book of Common Prayer to music. And I think that Alec Wyton, as organist, composer, hymnal editor, may have felt some kinship with Merbecke as he went on to explore new frontiers in Anglican music. Singing the excerpts was the Cathedral Choir of St. John the Divine from 1959. Those excerpts were taken from an old recording, and I've spliced them in before each movement of the suite. I'll close tonight's program by introducing three pieces played by Alec Wyton himself. First, Fidelis by Percy Whitlock, then the Fanfare by Francis Jackson, and finally, Alec's own arrangement of Lotus Blossom by Billy Strayhorn. This last was recorded live at the funeral of Duke Ellington. I've certainly felt a kinship with Alec and all the cathedral musicians who have gone before in preparing and recording this birthday tribute. And I'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Alec Wyton and to thank his son Richard, who provided many of the images and sound clips used in tonight's program. From all of us at St. John the Divine, past, present, and future, stay safe and may God bless you all.